Okay, we'll call the RTA meeting to order. Mr. Brown, do we have any calls to the audience?
There are no calls.
Approval of the July 27th meeting summary?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Meeting passes unanimously.
How easy they got.
Consent agenda. I think we have one item. Item A.
Mr. Chair, that's again for information. If there's ever any,
anybody have a question on that? If not, we'll move on. Procurement of transit business for Sun Shuttle. Mr. McLaughlin.
Mr. Chair, I'll take that if I may. This is a request for purchasing two electric shuttles for the RTA Sun Shuttle in partnership with the City of Tucson and TEP. RTA received the federal grant to be able to purchase those electric vehicles. RTA's share was for two shuttles, and obviously there's a 20% match requirement that the federal grants would allow us to participate in. So this is board's direction to me to authorize me to proceed with the purchase of those two vehicles, and be happy to answer any questions. And Preston's here as well. If there's any questions, be happy to answer your questions.
Move to approve.
Second. Oh, are you taking notes? Moved and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
And I don't know if there's any opposition, but just to add, I'm really happy to see this moving forward, and the new electric shuttles and EV charging stations are coming to our region as a result of regional collaboration. I'm really happy that we're able to move forward with this.
That was easy. All right. Thank you.
We're good. Okay, item six, RTA next plan. Mr. Barghamy.
Mr. Chair, members of the board, again, thank you for the opportunity to give you an update on the status of the development of the RTA next plan. If you recall at the last meeting, the board gave very specific direction to the CAC as well as the TNC to continue to work on developing the draft plan and have it to you at the next meeting in December. We've had multiple meetings with the CAC and at least one meeting with the TMC. The updated cost estimates have been provided to both committees. We have double-checked, cross the T's, dot the I's. I think everybody's comfortable with the updated cost estimates, but at the same time, it continues to be a challenge because the cost estimates are increasing and the budget is obviously limited. So as part of that exercise, and I'll have Chairman McGovern talk more about that, as part of that effort, the CAC is undertaking a kind of a revisit and ranking of the list of projects. That assignment is due, actually, it was due yesterday, and hopefully we'll have the results for the CAC at their next meeting. So they're looking at rearranging the priority of the 33 projects, as well as seeing what they can fit within the budget. So other than that, we hope to continue to have CAC and TMC to continue to work together, refine the plan, and bring it back to you by December. So both Mr. Rosema and DeBonis, obviously, as our CAC liaisons, have been participating as well. But I can have Mr. McGovern come up and give his update as well.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. The CAC is really focused and has been for the last, since I last talked to you, on two primary points of emphasis, first being transit. The transit element has been worked and reworked by the committee, by the entire committee. We had originally had a subcommittee, which presented kind of a foundational start to that element of the plan. And since then, it's been, as I say, worked some more. And currently, we are looking at both how to distribute money within it, within the element of transit, as well as exactly how much should be allocated to it. And that leads kind of into the second point of emphasis for the committee, which is, as Mr. Mugini just mentioned, the ranking of projects. We realized that any change in the allocations within each of the elements of the plan would likely, if they impacted the corridor projects, result in reductions of projects that could be funded under that category. The result of that has been that we recognized that there were several ranking exercises that have been done both by the TMC, by the jurisdictions themselves, and by the CAC on a couple of occasions. And as a result, we didn't have really a up-to-date ranking of our projects. And we also recognized, as a result of seeing the change, the cost estimates that came in several hundred million dollars above our kind of benchmark $1.1 billion original estimate, that we definitely had work to do about identifying projects that could be funded with that money, only to further potentially complicate that if there is a reduction in the amount of money to be devoted to those named corridor projects, then of course that exercise will have to go another step further, which is to further determine which projects can and can't be built within that category. Hope that didn't get too confusing, but essentially we are in that process, and we have started on and have made some good progress on a couple of exercises. One is to identify those projects necessary. Let me put it a different way. To find out which projects the committee believes should be funded and could be funded with our $1.1 billion benchmark amount for the corridors, knowing that not all of the 33 that had originally made it to this level could be paid for with that limited amount of budget. The second part of the work that we've embarked on is to rank the projects, as Mr. Mugini mentioned, from 1 to 33. There being 33 projects, we felt that a good starting point for determining where cutoffs would be to say, what is the overall ranking? What does the committee think are the most important and perhaps the least important of those 33 projects? One way to start that process is to rank them from 1 to 33. That's only a starting point, of course, because we still have to look at jurisdictional and geographic spread of projects and understand which projects perhaps are and why they may not show as highly on our scoring, which ones may be higher than the committee believes. So, you know, that this is kind of where the sausage making is going to occur. And hopefully we'll be getting to that at our next meeting, which is on Monday. So sorry to take so much time explaining where we are, but I thought it might be helpful for you to at least see what our focus is right now and ask if you have any questions.
Mr. Chair, I just had a quick question, Tom. Well, first, thank you for hanging in there. Really appreciate that, as always. And do you see the likelihood that by December, you think you could get to a consensus, or do you see, as a chance that we may have to get presented two different plans, one probably a little more TMC sort of centric and one CAC. I know you're probably hoping that it doesn't happen, but at some point we have to get something and let the regional council figure out, hopefully unanimously, but at least the majority of to move forward to finally get it to be put out to the voters.
Mr. Mayor, Mayor Murphy, I don't anticipate that that the CAC will fail to present a proposal. And it will be a proposal that has been vetted with the Technical Management Committee as well. And hopefully we do have time for several back and forths. To the extent that we're able, both of us, able to come to a conclusion, then certainly it's reasonable to expect that you would have that by the December date. I don't know whether it's reasonable that we'll come to an exact agreement, but that remains to be seen. But I'm still confident that that can very well happen. I guess I'll leave it at that.
Thanks, appreciate it. And your hard work and effort.
Any other questions?
Yeah.
Aaron, we're around.
Thank you so much for your service with the CAC. How, if there's any plans for the CAC to interact with the different jurisdictions, is that planned? How will the CAC and the citizen advisors be able to hear from the different wants and needs from the separate jurisdictions in the region?
Thank you for that question, Mr. Chairman and Mayor Romero. We currently have a process of communicating with the jurisdictions that mostly goes directly through the TMC. And so we'll ask jurisdictions to report back to us through that liaison that we have. And when we have specific questions or requests, that's the pathway that we typically use. I will say with regard to the transit communications we've been having, we've had more conversations directly with the jurisdictions at our meetings and in between. Those are often in the realm of the transit working group, which includes all of the affected transit providers and users in the region. So those are the primary ways that we've been communicating with those jurisdictions, but we regularly have reports from such folks as your DOT director and others. So if anyone feels that there's a better way or more is needed, our door is always open to that input.
I just feel as though it would be great. We just had a good presentation from Sam Credio, our Department of Transportation and Mobility, at a mayor and council meeting. Because of course we're looking at numbers, we're looking at estimates, and we as a mayor and council, based on the Move Tucson engagement program that we received from thousands of Tucsonans, are putting together our list of priorities. And I know that we either did or are about to present to the TMC, but it would be a great presentation for the entire CAC to be able to witness. And I would encourage other jurisdictions to do the same thing. So I just wonder if that is a possibility of coming to present based on what mayor and council have given direction of.
Certainly. And we discussed it in our last meeting as well, that the committee definitely wants to hear that feedback and that proposed method of prioritizing projects and transportation plan from the city. And we have had several Move Tucson presentations over the past several years. And so the committee regularly refers to Move Tucson in order to check in to see if the direction we're going makes sense with that and with other plans within the community, including, of course, the RTA's own long-range transit plan and long-range transportation plan, both.
So what would be the appropriate, how would we go about as a city of Tucson to request an item be scheduled for the CEC agenda to present?
I think you just did.
Okay. All right. I'm just asking because sure. It would be great for...
Is there a time that makes more sense?
I actually haven't even asked this question. I just came up with the... I just thought about it right now that you were presenting, that it would be nice to be able to have the same conversation that mayor and council had to the CAC.
Other questions? Thank you.
Is that for Tom, Mr. Chair? I do have a couple of questions on the RTA next item. So, but I thank you, Tom. I don't have any questions.
Mr. Rosemar or Mr. DeBonis want to comment on this as well. I think they're trying to get out the door. And okay, that was item A. Are there any other questions or Mayor Romero?
Yes, I just wanted to ask questions to staff in terms of the current RTA programming. And it relates to the RTNX. Based on current cost estimate to complete projects, are there any concerns about delivering the first RTA, the RTA 2006, aside from the four projects that we have identified to move to the RTA next? Because there are still projects that, especially City of Tucson, is working on. So are there any concerns in terms of cost estimates? Or work that is happening now that we might not be able to deliver additional projects besides the four that we chose to move forward if there was a need.
Mr. Chair, Mayor Romero, the four projects that were acted on by the board to move to RTA next. The estimate, the updated estimate is about $8 million more than what we had estimated. I think it's manageable. We can still continue to have the RTA next dialogue with those four projects. The remaining projects ongoing cost estimates are coming in. And as you recall, the direction from the board was to utilize other regional funds to complete those projects. So I do not anticipate any concerns. I think utilizing additional regional funds will budget those projects beyond 2026, which was the direction from the board initially.
There's some concerns that the Grant Road Phases 5 and 6 first RTA project, RTA is not releasing right-of-way money. Saying that the project may be deferred. Is there certain issues, concerns that we're...
No, and I think we're getting a little bit off the agenda, RTA next versus current RTA, but no, the RTA planning process over the next 5 years, that is ongoing. We're having those conversations with the committees. We'll be able to meet funding for those projects.
Thank you.
Any other comments? What's next? We have a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
So moved.
All of us.
Everybody made the motion. All in favor.
Aye.
We are adjourned.